I'm Gita Thanarajasingam, and I'm one of the lymphoma physicians here at Mayo Clinic. I am also involved in research about side effects of lymphoma treatment and for treatment of cancers in general. In the last 10 to 15 years, there have been huge changes in how we treat cancer. The disease I treat, lymphoma, used to be treated almost exclusively with intravenous chemotherapies. Now, many patients are on oral drugs, pills that they take every day, and these have completely different side effects. So one thing I'm very interested in is hearing more from the patient perspective about side effects. When we study new drugs, we're always looking at side effects, and your doctor is grading them, so to speak, meaning assessing how serious or severe a side effect is. A lot of research has been done that suggests that it's patients that can provide us further information. I can't really tell if the fatigue you're experiencing on a drug is intolerable for you. I need that information from you directly. And so we're now using tools that allow us to assess patient-reported outcomes in the monitoring of side effects. And how we take that information from patients and how we analyze it to inform us as your doctors is what I'm focused on. Patients are their own best advocates, and they know what is or isn't tolerable to them. We're harnessing technology, such as mobile devices, to collect this information from patients directly and have it inform the clinician's perspective on whether a drug is safe and is it tolerable to a patient. Is it something that they would want to continue to take at the right dose over time to treat their cancer? And I think there's been an increasing emphasis on tolerability of therapy. It shouldn't only be about, well, can you survive on the drug? It should be, can you tolerate well? Can you live well on your cancer therapy? One thing we haven't done a very good job of recording when we're studying new drugs or cancer treatment is when do side effects happen? For example, if you get a rash that happens 7 to 10 days on treatment, that's very different than a rash that might come 2 or 3 months on treatment. And knowing that information may help me as your doctor come up with the creams or medicines you need to use to manage that side effect. And if you as the patient manage that side effect, you might say, hey, taking that drug was tolerable to me. Whereas if you have a terrible rash that your doctor didn't know was likely to come up on the 7th or 10th day of treatment, that treatment may be really, really difficult for you to bear. One of the reasons that I'm most proud to work at Mayo Clinic is our focus on the patient as the center of the treatment experience. And that allows us to say, not only do we care about the newest, the most important, and the most effective treatments, but the impact of those treatments on our patients as people